on the injectors, you know, a couple passes of that, and then we ought to be ready to go.
So John and Brian got the car up on the dyno and started running a baseline. I mean, yeah, the engine sounded great, but I could see right away that something wasn't right on the computer. I should be getting a 3,000 RPM sample out of this engine, but right now I'm only getting 500.
Hey, there's not much there, is it?
It's redlining pretty quick.
I suspect that the lack of horsepower is a product of the torque converter. If the one that I installed is not the right match for this setup, the transmission and the engine will never operate efficiently together.
If that's the case, then we need to get back to shop and get in and get on a lift and pull a converter.
That's pretty much what it is.
Okay, I guess we're going back to back here.
At this late date, the only thing I can do now is pull the transmission, install a different torque converter, and roll the dice with that one. If we can't get enough power from the engine to the back wheels, well, this race we're trying to win might just end up being on foot.
Tony's job, which he does sometimes, is to go through the internet and check all of our emails we get of people trying to sell us cars.
Yeah, this one came out of Tennessee to Ford F-100.
Bottom line is, the guys are willing to drive from Tennessee with a truck that they're wanting around $2,000 for. We get to see it. We don't have to go travel. How you guys doing?
Pretty good myself.
How was the drive in?
A little bit long, but good. My name's Chris. I'm trying to get to Tennessee. Brought my white feather with me, and we're here to sell the